Hi, Theater Arts. Welcome to your Foley sound design assignment. So, if you have not watched the video from the film A Quiet Place that I've linked into your assignment, please go back and watch that one. That video goes over what Foley is and how Foley artists use everyday objects to create different sound effects. So, if you haven't watched that one, please go back and watch it. For the rest of y'all who are ready to proceed with the assignment, what we're going to be doing is you guys are going to be looking for different everyday objects in your home or wherever you're staying right now that you could use for sound effects. And so I'm going to show you guys a picture. This picture has the options for all the different options for Foley sound design. These are just ideas. If you have different sound effects that you want to try and show, you're more than welcome to do them. For your assignment, what you're going to be doing is you're going to be choosing three sounds. You're going to find items to make those sound effects at home, and you're going to show me in a Flipgrid video. So right now, what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be going through some examples of little different objects that I found at home that I could use for Foley sound effects. So the first one is my trusty flashlight that we have seen in several other videos if you did the lighting design assignments. What I'm going to do is by clicking this on and off button on the flashlight, I'm going to try and simulate the ticking of a clock. So hopefully you could hear that noise. This one depends kind of like on your timing, right? Trying to get it exactly close to the 1 second, 2 second, 3 second. But that's my example for a ticking clock. Remember with Foley, you want to use objects that are different than the object that you're trying, than the sound effect that you're trying to make. So flashlight, I'm using it to simulate a clock. The next one is going to be, I'm going to use this straw to make like kind of like a wind blowing sound. So hopefully you guys can hear that. The sound of my breath going through the straw, that's what's making that kind of like wind type sound. The next one I'm going to do is the clip clopping of a horse. So I have one pill inside this pill bottle. So it rattles around maybe a little too much for the clip-clopping of a horse, but it's a similar sound, right? Like, and so my last example that I'm going to be doing, or I have two more left. My second to last example is I'm going to use the opening of this bag and the bag itself to make some kind of rustling noises to kind of simulate the sound of fire. So this is me trying to do like the sound of like logs crackling in the fire. So I did that just by like closing different parts of the lid and rustling the plastic bag. You could even probably do that one with like a HEB bag too. That might work. And so the last one, this one is just kind of like a fun little popping sound. So this would be, you could use this for any sound effect that you were trying to use popping. See, it's just a, this one's just a fun sound to me. Like, how fun is that, right? Anyway, so those are my examples. You don't have to do the same examples that I did. Like I said, I'm attaching a picture of that list of ideas of different sound effects that you can do. So when you're turning in this assignment, just these are a couple of reminders for you guys. When you're doing the assignment, you're going to tell me when you're doing the Flipgrid, you are going to tell me what sound effect you're trying to do. So I'm trying to do the crackling of logs in a campfire. You're going to tell me what you're using. So I'm using a plastic bag and the closure of the plastic bag. And then you're going to demonstrate the sound for me. As long as I can hear the sound, your assignment is complete. If you are feeling a little shy and you want to like cover your face with the emoji like some of y'all have been doing, that's okay. If you want to do the sound kind of off camera, that's fine. On camera is fine too. What's most important for this assignment is that I actually hear the sounds. All right. So once you make your video and post it to Flipgrid, you're going to come back to your Google Classroom assignment and you are going to click return. And so you clicking return, that is what is letting me know that you have turned in the assignment, and then I'll go and check it on Flipgrid. So please make sure that you do that, guys. If you need help, if you're confused on the instructions, please always, always, always feel free to email me, message me on Remind or on our class Instagram or anything like that. Please reach out. And guys, continue working on your assignments, not just for my class, but for all your classes. I hope you have fun with this assignment. Be creative. See what sounds you can come up with at home. All right. Bye, guys. See you later.